Hi, my name is Benjamin Musser. I'm a residential realtor in Northern Virginia, and I would like to thank you for watching my vlog, Towns Apart, The Local at Heart.
I am Lee Owsley. My husband Terry and I are owners of Latitudes Fair Trade store in Warrenton and Fredericksburg, Virginia. At Latitudes Fair Trade, our vision is to provide our local communities with the opportunity to purchase beautifully crafted, unique things from all around the world that people can feel really great about buying and using and sharing, because they know that these items were made by people who were paid fairly. So it's a win-win situation. We are in our communities bringing beautiful things to our communities that are also helping the global community. And that's what we feel makes us really unique and special, and just makes us so happy about getting up and going to work every day. The seed idea for Latitudes was born about 10 years ago when I did a language immersion school in Guatemala and took a weaving class with a co-op of Guatemalan women who produced beautiful things. And on the way home, I chided myself for not buying more of their products to give to my friends as gifts, because it was a lovely co-op and these women really could use some marketing. And that gave me the idea to start Latitudes. And so I began just selling online a little bit and in local markets, and could see that people really did grasp the idea that it was wonderful to be able to buy a product that helped the people that made it as well. And I started opened Latitudes in Warrenton in the fall of in December of 2010, and was in a smaller location until just this past October, and then moved up here to 78 Main Street and have expanded into a size twice as big. The mission of Fair Trade is to provide long-term sustainable employment to people who would otherwise have very, very little chance of providing for themselves. And the way it works is that there is a group, sometimes an ex-Peace Corps person or a missionary or a State Department person, that works alongside a group, a co-op usually, of people in a country, and helps them with product development, sometimes small business loans, marketing, and helps them really develop products that are beautifully done and sustainable, and also things that people in our market would like to purchase. They get those things here, they help us find those things, and it's a way for not just people to have employment once or twice, but to really have something long-term so that they can send their kids to school, they can really forge a whole new way of life for themselves and then for a whole community of people. And it's also a way that our community can get beautifully crafted things that you would not be able to find in many other places. And so it's a real win-win. We are getting beautiful things and people are having sustainable employment. It's a partnership. So currently we have products in the store from about 40 different countries, and we have about 70 different groups that we source from in order to get those products. A product that we have in the store that has a very memorable story for me is our pine needle baskets that are made by a group of women in the highlands of Guatemala, and they actually use pine needles. They're very long not like we're used to, very long pine needles. They bundle them, and then they use raffia to tie them together into intricate patterns. And we have visited this group several times. They're really well run with an NGO from the United States. And these women, it's a particularly lovely story because most of them are widows from a civil war in Guatemala. And being women and being widows and in a country with very high unemployment, they would have almost no way to provide for themselves and their families. But by being part of this co-op, they are have a lovely livelihood and lovely camaraderie, and they make beautiful baskets that are now sold even in the Smithsonian gift shop in downtown DC. And we went and visited them two Februarys ago, and our idea was going to be to make a basket with them. They were going to show us how. And I can tell you, after about 2 minutes of trying that, I realized my hands were not nearly strong enough to do what they do every day. So I have really high respect for these women and for all of the group that's around them, and the way the baskets are they're made and the way they're managed in country and in the United States. So Mayan Hands is one of our favorite groups. The tagline on our logo is Shop for Good. It has a dual meaning. It means that it is a shop that is for the good of the world, because we pay people, the artisans, fairly. And then we also want people to shop for good in the sense of being conscious shoppers. So we really, even though we sell things and we want people to buy our things, we want people to think about these things. And we feel like our products are beautiful things that would be treasured over the long term. Even the clothing is made well, and it's not throwaway clothing. It's a slow process. So we're hoping that people will come in and buy things that will be given as gifts, that will be treasured for years and years, and that's reflected in the quality of the things that we have in the store. We don't have things that are going to hopefully not break, hopefully not be thrown out, but things that are going to last. So they're not contributing to short-term to landfills. They're going to be highly treasured. So I love all the products in the store, but I have to say one of my absolutely favorite products is our roll-on bracelets, and I find that I wear these almost every single day. And they have a special place in my heart because my daughter Emily and I went to Nepal and visited one of the places where these bracelets are made, and that it was a group that was started by a man who was in the Peace Corps in Nepal. And he developed the design with the folks that he was working with, and has gone on to continue to produce beautiful roll-on bracelets. And I think it's been about 20 years now since he was in Nepal, and now I think there are over 500 folks in Nepal that make these bracelets, and they're really well made, they're beautifully designed, and they're just the kind of thing that you keep forever and ever. So that's why I love my roll-on bracelets. When the initial idea came to me on my trip home from Guatemala that I wanted to have a store and sell things that women make in other countries, immediately my thought was I wanted a store on the main street of Warrenton. It never occurred to me that it would be anywhere else, and that's because I have lived in Warrenton since 1990. I love this community. I was a teacher in the community for 8 years, and the people here are wonderful, amazing, generous, warm, friendly. It's just a loving, loving community. My four children went to school all through the school system here. We just have deep roots here, and I love this community. And I think that is a big reason for the success of the store, is just the warmth and the generosity of the Warrenton community. And likewise, we have found lovely communities also in Fredericksburg and Stanton. But my original thought was that this is where it had to start. I think the biggest thing that I've learned is how a small, simple idea, if it's planted well, and I think mine was divinely planted, honestly, can just grow and germinate and produce beautiful fruit. The store started as a pop-up, basically, and with almost very, very little inventory, with a string of volunteers. I was still working full-time as a teacher. But all of those things, it just continued to grow bit by bit by bit, slowly, slowly. And now there are 3 Latitude stores, and we all sell way, way more than we ever thought we would in the beginning. It's just been a lovely labor of love that's grown slowly over time. So it was a little thing, but it was well planted and well watered, and it's grown into a lovely, beautiful flower.